You know, my father and his brothers immigrated here, and they had an uncle who was living here. So the uncle came to America and never heard from him, and then he went back to Jordan, and they said, oh, he's like, I'm living in Cincinnati, and so they followed him. And, you know, they worked their way, worked very hard. I mean, my dad barely spoke English when he came to this country in the mid-50s. And then they decided to really focus on the chili business, and they opened Gold Star Chili in Mount Washington. We met at a Bacchanalian Wine Society, which is a quarterly wine tasting, and the money goes to a charity. And a mutual friend introduced us, and I wasn't really that crazy about it. Not in the sense, I mean, I was just, you know, our mutual friend said, oh, you know, he sits on city council. And I just said, oh, I'm not too fond of city council right now. And so John just like, you know, like walked away. And then he's like, okay.
All right.
And then about 3 days later, I was at an American Heart Association fundraiser, and he was there. And he totally like just like walked right up to me, and we talked for like 3 hours. And
so
he asked me out.
Two charity events.
And then he asked me out and called me the next day and took me to Boca for dinner. And at that moment, on our first date, I knew I was going to marry him. You know, I think he hopes to, you know, become mayor the next round. You know, he has 3 more years left in this office, and I think he wants to run again for another 4 years. Anything after that, I haven't said anything. I haven't talked to him about it.
Deep breaths.
Yeah. So
it's overwhelming. Is the whole political thing?
It is a little overwhelming. Yes, a lot of moving parts, a lot of energy, a lot of factors to consider. I think people think, you know, he would be a great governor. I think he would be a great governor, but we live in Cincinnati, and so.